So in this video, we are going to be talking about different methods of transportation here in China, but more specifically here in Beijing. We are going to be trying out a few of the different transportation methods. We're going to be talking about the prices and other details about them. And for part of the video, Yongka is my assistant. He's going to be helping me out. And then for the other part, my friend Sue is going to be helping me out. So, yes.
Are you excited?
Yes.
Okay, so let's get started. So one of the methods of transportation here in China is going by bus. And so the bus fee is 2 kuai, no matter where you go, it's always 2 kuai. And this is what the signs look like. So they go by numbers. And then it tells you where each route goes to. So these are all the different stops. And China is not travel friendly. It's not a place where you can see a lot of English signs. So it is pretty difficult to travel on your own if you don't know any Chinese. You at least need a phone to help you translate things. This is what you're going to see. So then you get to see this is where you are right now, and then where you can go, and then how many stops that'll be. And yeah, as you can see, it's 2 kuai, 2 kuai. They're all 2 kuai.
Come on, guys, come on. Do you have a bus pass?
No.
I have money.
Okay, so you can either use your subway card or cash. So if you have cash, then you just put it inside the box. This is a very big bus. They have different sizes. They have some that are 2 meters. They have one that is just like one bus size. And this one is kind of like double one. So you see here they have this extension. And so they have lots of seats. So people can sit anywhere. If you see somebody old that needs a chair, then you stand there for them. But if there's nobody around, you just sit down, it's fine. And then they also have seats in the back as well. Or you can just stand up. And yeah, if the bus gets fuller, like if it's rush hour, then you just stand. By the way, guys, we don't know where we're going. We just got a random bus and to film this. So when you get off, for example, Yongka didn't use a card, he just used cash, so he doesn't need to do anything. So then another method of transportation here in China is scooters, bicycles, motorcycles, and yeah, for example, that was a scooter. And so a lot of the streets, not all of them, but a lot of the streets have their own section for bicycles only. But this is also where cars like to park. But you also feel safer because there's no cars like going at fast speeds here. This is like specially for bicycles and scooters to go by here. Yeah, that's what you see. And then on the other side, that's where the fast cars go and they're going at normal speeds. Another method of transportation is using these bikes that you can rent. So they have different companies. As you can see, there's these yellow ones, there's blue ones, there's orange ones, there's red ones. But so I'm signed up to the yellow company. So here it shows you like where they're all at. And so, well, here there's one. And so I'm going to scan it. Okay, so this is the password. And so it opens up. And so now I can use the bike. And so it's 1 kuai for every half an hour, or it just gave me the option if I wanted to pay 4 kuai for the whole week. But so, you know, they have different like specials every time. So like the last time I paid 5 kuai for a whole month, and you can use it as many times as you want. So anyways, I'm going to use this for a second. anywhere, and then you just have to lock it. I just press this down, and it's locked. So, that's it. Another method of transportation is using a taxi or a regular car, kind of like an Uber, but here in China we use an app called Didi, and so usually you don't see people kind of calling the taxi by hand anymore, you just use the application, and then both a regular car and a taxi start at around 13 kwai, and I think it's pretty affordable, but we're going to be taking a taxi right now, so let's go. So here's the app, and I just called one. I just have to wait for somebody to accept. Okay, so we got one. So this is the taxi, and he's going to be taking us to our destination. So it says that he's right here, and he'll be here in 5 minutes. So this taxi ride took about 20 minutes and it's going to be around 30 kwai, and I'm going to be paying with my phone. An application called WeChat, which is the messenger app here in China, and everything is paid with WeChat nowadays. So I paid the bicycle with WeChat, I paid the sanlunjiao with WeChat, and also taxi fees. And if you were wondering, also like when you go to the supermarket or anything, it's always paid with WeChat. So. So this is another method of transportation, which is the subway. So first you have to have a subway card to be able to take the subway. And so I have very little money on it right now, so I'm going to charge it. And my friend Sue is right here, and I'm going to get her a subway card as well. So I'm going to put 50 in mine and 50 in hers. So come. So the subway can cost 3 to 5 kwai depending on the distance. To get into the subway, you have to just swipe your card and then pass your bag through the security check, which they check if you have any alcohol or any sharp objects or anything like dangerous. Another thing that you see a lot here in Beijing are these windows, which protect people from jumping in front of the subway, which I've heard happens a lot. Like for example, in Australia, people like to jump in front of the trains. So this protects people, and yeah, I think it's very safe, so nobody gets hurt. And I think it's very convenient. I think the subway in China is much less confusing than the ones in Korea, Japan, and New York. I think the map is very easy, and there aren't like express trains or regular trains. Like there's just one train that goes to one destination, so it's pretty easy. And then there's always maps like this. Over here, there's always a map, and that can help you figure out your way. This TV here lets you know when the next one is coming and the one after that. And they come every 4 to 5 minutes. So people don't really rush into the subway because like the next one comes very quickly. This is Sue. So yeah, there's chairs for you to sit, or you can hold on to this or these right here. And then there's these lights which tell you where it's going to stop next. And there are lots of screens where they show you in what station you're at and what time it is, and then they sometimes have like some commercials. They also have commercials here on the outside.
elevators everywhere, so it's very easy. You don't have to walk.
And so usually here in Beijing, you want to stand on the right side if you just want to stand, and then the left side is for people who are in a rush and then they walk quickly. So you want to stand on the right side. This is another method of transportation. I'm going to be taking a sanluancha, which is a three-wheeled car. So let's get in. So this is usually a very bumpy ride.
Okay, so this is our final destination. Let's go. We're not completely all the way up. We have done a lot of stairs, but we still have more to go.
Another transportation method is obviously owning a car, and owning a car is sometimes a little difficult here in China because since it's overpopulated, they don't want everybody to have a car, so they make it a little difficult. It's kind of difficult to own a license plate, and so it's very expensive, and they do it by lotteries, so not everybody gets a chance to own a car. Only some people get to own a car. But I wouldn't say it's a very convenient thing to have in Beijing because, you know, there's a lot of traffic and there aren't parking spaces everywhere. So I think you do waste more time if you own a car than if you were to use a taxi or if you were to go by subway. If you're going long distances, maybe it'll be convenient, but for the regular person that kind of lives near their job, I would not recommend owning a car. Okay guys, so that is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and learning about the different methods of transportation.